Tucker Carlson, a Fox News primetime host and one of the most popular TV personalities, left the network with immediate effect on Monday. His departure caused Fox Corporation to lose $690 million in market value and sparked speculation over his next landing spot. Investors bought shares of Rumble Incorporated and Digital World Acquisition Corporation, two companies backed by Peter Thiel and Donald Trump, respectively. Carlson's show, Tucker Carlson Tonight, is the top-rated primetime show on cable TV, with an average of more than 3.7 million viewers. It is also one of the most watched shows on cable TV, excluding sports. Hunter Biden, the son of President Biden, is facing a paternity case in Arkansas over his unacknowledged 4-year-old daughter, Navy Jones Roberts. He must appear in person for a hearing on May 1 in Batesville, where a judge ruled that he and his attorney must attend every proceeding. The judge also questioned his attorney about the laptop that he allegedly left at a repair shop, which reportedly contained some income tax records. The judge denied his request for a restraining order. E. Jean Carroll, a writer who says Donald Trump raped her in a department store in the 1990s, is suing him for defamation after he denied her allegations and called her a liar. The jury selection started on Tuesday in federal court in Manhattan. Carroll's lawyer said she wants to get her life back, while Trump's lawyer said she is doing this for money and political reasons. Carroll said she told two friends about the attack and has a photo of her and Trump at an event. Trump said he never met her and mistook her for his ex-wife Marla Maples in the photo. The judge will allow testimony from two other women who accused Trump of sexual assault and the Access Hollywood tape. The New York Climate Exchange, a $700 million project to build a 400,000-square-foot climate center on Governor's Island, was announced by Mayor Eric Adams on Monday. The project aims to create cleaner, greener solutions for New Yorkers and the world, and to inspire the next generation of climate leaders. The project will be led by Stony Brook University, which will also lead green research there. The center will be covered with solar panels and geothermal energy, and will provide electricity to the grid. It will also have classrooms, research space, and laboratories for green education and innovation. Evan Gershkovich, a Wall Street Journal reporter, is detained in Russia on espionage charges for allegedly collecting secret information on Russia's military-industrial complex. He and his employer have denied the allegations. More than 300 foreign news correspondents from 22 countries sent a letter to the Russian foreign minister asking him to drop the charges and release Gershkovich. They said Gershkovich was a journalist who sought out information to inform his readers about the current reality in Russia, and that his arrest was a disturbing and dangerous signal about Russia's disregard for independent media. The World Health Organization, WHO, warned of a huge biological risk after one of the warring parties in Sudan occupied the Central Public Health Laboratory in Khartoum, where polio, measles, and cholera isolates are stored. The laboratory is extremely dangerous and not properly managed due to power cuts and lack of access by technicians. The conflict in Sudan has killed hundreds and displaced thousands since April, and a 3-day ceasefire was announced on Monday by the US and Saudi Arabia. However, both sides of the fighting accused each other of violating the agreement and fired guns and jets over the capital. Joe Biden, the 46th president of the United States, announced on Tuesday that he is running for re-election in 2024, saying he wanted to finish the job he started amid a deadly pandemic, a reeling economy, and a teetering democracy. He claimed that his presidency has pulled the country back from the brink on all those fronts, and outlined his ambitious agenda to address climate change, healthcare, infrastructure, and other issues. He also warned of the dangers of a return of Donald Trump, who is expected to lead the Republican field. Alessandra Korup Munduruku, an indigenous woman from the Sormwaibu territory in the Amazon rainforest, won the Goldman Environmental Prize for her campaign against mining corporations. She led a campaign that forced Anglo-Americans to withdraw 27 research applications to mine on her land, which covers 400,000 acres of rainforest. Her campaign challenged the government's push for extraction in the Amazon and won recognition from the mining lobby. However, she still faces threats from illegal gold miners and a lack of formal recognition from the government. She plans to use the prize money to become a lawyer. General Motors Co. and Samsung SDI are expected to announce on Tuesday that they will build a new joint venture battery plant in the United States, sources told Reuters. The new plant will be more expensive than the $2.6 billion plant that GM and LG Energy Solution are building in Michigan, which will open in 2024. The two companies are considering several locations in North America for the new plant, including Indiana, where they previously looked at a site. The new plant is part of GM's ambitious plan to produce 400,000 EVs in North America by 2022 and 1 million by 2025, and to meet the growing demand for EV batteries. Harry Belafonte, a singer, actor, producer, and activist who sparked a calypso craze in the US and blazed new trails for African American performers, died on Tuesday of congestive heart failure at his Manhattan home. He was 96. He won two Grammy Awards, a Tony and an Emmy, and received the Jean Herzholt Humanitarian Award and the Motion Picture Academy's Jean Herzholt Humanitarian Award. He also helped organize the recording of We Are the World, the all-star benefit single for African famine relief. Belafonte was born in New York but grew up in Jamaica, where he learned calypso and mento music.
Thank you for watching. Please support our efforts by liking and sharing the videos. Don't forget to subscribe to get our regular updates.